The Kudzukian Network presents Riffin on Jazz with your host, Howard Robertson and Malvin Massey.
Sonny Rollins.
You got to improve, man. You got Coltrane and Ornette Coleman and these boys coming up. You better get your stuff together.
Mr. Miles Davis.
The white people are funny. They, in America, they thought that I just woke up one morning and had the blues and started playing the trumpet. But it don't go like that, and you can't explain that to them.
Miles was able to make something that was wrong into something that was right.
Now they know. I'm not an accident.
Hello and welcome to Riffin' on Jazz. I'm Howard Robertson.
And I'm Malvin Massey.
And of course, Riffin' on Jazz is your weekly visit with friends, talking about the music that we love.
The classic African-American art form called jazz.
Malvin. How you doing, man?
I'm good.
Good.
How about
to
yourself,
see you,
man?
Again. I'm well.
You've been in the motherland? And
yes,
you know,
yes,
and
yes. And I missed all of this. But I love, you should go to Africa, man. Go to South Africa first. It's the best.
Right on.
It's the best. Today, we are, you know, this season, Malvin, we're going to be doing some different things.
Yeah.
And this is indication and evidence of that. So today we've got a tasty jazz menu for our listeners. This show is full of epicureal delights, as you said.
Very good.
Yes. They're food songs. And the first thing up on the menu, we're going to begin to clean your palate and to cleanse your palate. And there's nothing better to do that than chili peppers.
Thank you.
Chili Peppers. Get that palate ready for some real food.
That was from The Right Touch. That was recorded in 68 from on the Blue Note label. And part of this show, too, is that we are going to touch on some artists that we've missed. Mm-hmm. You know, long ago, we said that there's so many jazz artists, so many good jazz artists.
Right.
That, when we do these best piano players, best saxophone players, and all, we're going to leave some people out.
Absolutely. So, like Columbus Calvin Duke Pearson Jr.
Exactly. Pearson. And one of the major piano players is his uncle named him Duke, nicknamed him Duke.
Why?
Because he admired Duke Ellington.
There you go. There you go.
And his mama taught him how to play the piano.
From a young age. I think he grew up in the Atlanta area, right?
Yeah, I think so. Yeah, that's where he was from.
And ended up going to...
With Clark College.
Clark College, which is, we know as Clark University in Atlanta, one of the HBCUs.
Yeah.
And
But he did that, but one time in his life, he started playing brass instruments. He was a piano player, but he started playing brass instruments. He got into that.
Mm-hmm.
And he did that. He fell, he dropped the piano, playing brass, trumpets, and stuff like that. And even when he got in the Army, he went to the Army band playing trumpet.
Oh, man. And just... who's who of people that he's been associated with, including Cannonball Adderley, including art farmer, including Clifford Brown, including Nancy Wilson, including who I miss.
Oh, yeah. And all of this, he in 63, he was the A&R guy for Blue Note. He's credited with directing Blue Note toward bebop.
Wow, wow, wow.
Yeah.
So, A Tasty Jazz Menu is where we are, and we've allowed you to cleanse your palate with some chili peppers.
Yeah.
And it's nothing ever in life, Malvin, better after some chili peppers than some what?
Some barbecue. Gotta have the barbecue.
Strutting with some barbecue. Some barbecue, baby.
Now, that ain't the first time we've played that song.
Yeah, we have played that song before.
That's the first time it's been a duet, and that's Lee Konitz. And we haven't talked about Lee in a while.
Nope.
Yeah, we
haven't talked about Lee. Man. We're about to.
Yeah,
but you know something.
Milestone,
you know something. You and I are both born and raised in Memphis, Tennessee. And, you know.
It's all about the barbecue.
It's all about the barbecue. You cannot be in this part of the world without having a special affinity for barbecue. And for us, barbecue is hog, baby. You know, don't come in here with all that beef.
No brisket here. No. We don't do that. That's a Texas thing.
That's a Texas thing. And they think they're barbecuing, man.
I know. You can't account for taste.
Ain't no big old tough beef ribs. It's pork ribs. Anyway, Lee Konitz, let's talk about him a little bit.
And he's still around.
Is he?
Yeah, he ain't gigging a lot. I think his last gig was 2014.
What? He's still around. He's born in 27.
Yeah.
Oh, man.
And he's an alto player extraordinaire. And he wrote a lot of music, too.
So he's still gigging?
Yeah,
no,
he was. He quit. He quit about 2015, I think. Something
okay.
Like that. Yeah.
Cause he's 90.
Yeah.
Oh wow. Oh okay. Yeah. So I here's what I'm most impressed about. So other sax players were strongly influenced by Lee Konitz, including Art Pepper and our guy, Paul Desmond.
Two cats that we have already talked about.
Already talked about. Yeah. Already talked about. Now, that about is that, interesting.
Though. Yeah, think about that, the range of Lee Konitz, and that he could influence these guys who have two different styles.
Right, basically. Right. So, okay, we have cleansed our palate with the chili peppers. We followed it with some fine barbecue. Where do we go now?
It's going to be my man, Johnny Griffin. Love my intro for my show. This time we're doing some hot sauce.
Yeah.
I do too. Plays. That's from Way Out. He recorded that in 1958 on Riverside.
Wow. Big, fat, sax sound.
He called him the
from
little
a little
giant.
Dude.
The little giant. Yeah, Johnny Griffin, he played a lot of major players.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Didn't he? T Monk, Thelonious Monk, Eddie Lockjaw Davis. He went to the ABU, Art Blakey University.
Yeah. And he when he was 15, he was playing with T Bone Walker.
Wow.
And that's where he got his big sound.
And
from,
then played all the way up to age 80, the month of his death. And he said, God gave me this gift to blow, and I'm going to blow till it's time to blow.
Well, I still play him every Sunday.
Hot sausage. And remember, if you love jazz, make sure you're tuning in to the latest episodes of Riffin' on Jazz by going to Kudzukian.com or by simply downloading the Kudzukian app. All you got to do is go to the App Store or Google Play. We are into a tasty jazz menu here on Riffin' on Jazz, and we'll be back for more Riffin' on Jazz on the Kudzukian Network right after this.
Riffin' on Jazz.
We're getting funky, y'all.
33% of Americans have a college degree. 43% of Africans in this country have a college degree. These are African immigrants that are coming to this country. They didn't have the opportunity and access, but they came over here in this American dream and created within this framework. Disparaging remark goes further than just told.
It's Funky Politics on the Kudzukian Network.
Hey, this is saxophonist Kirk Whalum, and you're listening to Riffin' on Jazz, powered by the Kudzukian Network.
Welcome back to the Tasty Jazz Menu episode of Riffin' on Jazz here with me and Malvin. We're having a good time. We hope you appreciate what's been on the menu so far. We're talking about food songs. Songs that have something whatsoever to do with some eating, right?
Right. And we are also picking up on some artists that we've not mentioned before.
Yes.
Some people whose names may not be known to a lot of jazz people.
Like this next one, James Graham Collier.
Yeah.
And the Graham Collier Septet.
Yeah. An English jazz bassist, band leader, composer, born in Tynemouth, Northumberland.
Born where?
Tynemouth, Northumberland.
Good. That's exactly what it said on
definitely
the paper.
In England. Yeah. Definitely in England. He got a scholarship to the Berklee School of Music. He's got that in common with so many cats.
Wow.
He got
a
scholarship to Berklee from Downbeat Magazine.
Yes, yes.
And he went there and graduated in 63.
And that's something. No, we have never talked about him. And he produced 19 albums and CDs. Was with groups and commissioned by festivals and broadcasters and all of that all across Europe and North America and Australia.
Yeah.
So how'd we miss him?
I don't know. Collier, he got his jazz degree course going at the London Royal Academy of Music. He was artistic director there until he resigned in 99.
Okay.
And, because Europeans love jazz more than we do.
Right.
In certain circumstances, it's not hard to believe that we'd have a cat who's so seriously into it. But also that we don't know anything about him.
But that's all right. We know something about him now. And all of that stuff that we just read, that doesn't matter. All that matters is we're about to get a good taste of Crumbling Cookie. Thank you.
Jazz with the Graham Collier Septet.
Yes.
Tune Crumbling Cookie from the CD Deep Blue Center. Deep,
all right.
Dark Blue Center.
See, I'm really glad that we're doing this, man, because this gives us an opportunity, as you said, to really cover some cats that we hadn't covered before. Yeah. And if it took talking about some food on
no
the Tasty Jazz
it.
Menu, there's no better way to do it, like you said. Like you said. So that's going to bring us to cat named Freddie McCoy.
Now, we did a whole thing on Viplayers.
We did a whole thing on Viplayers, but we didn't do Freddie McCoy.
No. And the name of everybody else is mentioned on this.
Yep. Like, OK, Cal Jada, Bobby Hutcherson, Gary McFarlane, Gary Burton, all of those cats. But we didn't talk about a cat that's supposed to be the greatest soul vibraphonist.
Of all time.
yeah, vibist. So, and that's what Freddie McCoy was. I mean, he really has a very broad background.
Yeah.
And played with a lot of cats, including our guy, Bernard Pretty Purdy. who, for those of you who don't know, Bernard Purdy was a drummer extraordinaire. Had more foot than anybody.
I'm telling you.
And most notably, played with Aretha on all of Aretha Franklin's cuts.
And this cat, Freddie McCoy, played with Johnny Hamlin Smith, played with Joanne Brackeen. And he, you know what? He decided to go hippie and cut out from the music for a minute. But this one here, Freddie McCoy, we talk about beans and greens.
Beans and greens, baby.
Thank you.
why they call them a jazz soul vibes. Yes, that was
Freddie McCoy from the Beans and Greens CD released 1968 on the press.
Beans and greens. We've got a tasty jazz menu today here on Riffin' on Jazz. Hope you're enjoying it. Hope you're enjoying the food. And everything, you know, is food driven for us today. And we thought that you might like it. Yeah, obviously, food is a big factor for musicians.
For most mammals, actually.
Nah, but particularly for jazz musicians. Yeah. Jazz musicians love to eat. And so many jazz musicians remember stops, remember cities, not based on the venue or where they played, but based on where they ate and what they ate.
So we're going ahead for some more greens.
Oh. Is that what we got coming up on the other side of this break?
Yeah.
All right. Y'all stick with us. We got more Riffin' on Jazz on the Kudzukian Network after this.
I expect to go to Coachella in a helicopter. Moroccan type.
This is why we came to the Kudzukian Network.
The next Beachella, they going to drop us on the stage. It's going to be like BNP sick. We going to sell out on the black people and make me feel safe.
It's amazing.
Yes.
Absolutely amazing. Yeah.
You sell out with white people, scary.
I know.
I feel like with the people here at Kudzukian, once we sell out, like, they'll be the ones to be like, all right, y'all acting real life skin.
Simmer down.
Right.
Y'all acting real life skin.
On the Kudzukian Network.
Kudzukian. And we're riffing on jazz, a tasty jazz menu, as it were.
That's right.
And we're doing food songs and different artists. Different artists, not new artists, because most of these cats have already been.
Now, interest of full disclosure, this was whose idea? This show was whose idea?
It was mine.
It's your idea. Mine. That's exactly right. I think it was a good one.
I like picking up on some of these new artists.
I like these artists too. Now, I want to point out something that I hope everybody doesn't miss and is getting. The vast majority of these artists and this food that they are talking about is soul food. And these are very soulful kind of artists. And this next one is no different. Freddie Roach.
Yeah, it's in the description of the music.
From New York. Right. Hammond B3 Cat and played just his face off. plays very, very soulfully. He's a son of an organist, a church organist. And, you know, you don't get more soulful than that.
He's his right hand.
Playing up in the Baptist church, baby.
Yeah.
Missionary Baptist church. Or if you want some more, if you really, really, really want to get going, the Sanctified Church.
Yeah. And something else, we were just talking about it. Most of these cats have an association with Blue Note.
Yes.
It was Blue Note in the 60s.
They were big.
Yeah.
Malvin, I mean, you know, you had Blue Note, Prestige. You had to have some connections and some to be legit.
Yeah, be accepted. And this cat, and like we said, so we had a Freddie earlier, and he was doing Beans and Greens,
mm-hmm.
and it's another Freddie, and he got more greens.
More greens.
Please.
Thank you. Wonder what kind of greens Freddie Roach was playing about.
I don't know.
Collard greens, turnip greens, mustard greens. Wonder what kind of greens he was talking about. He was playing about, I should say. More greens, please.
Yeah. 1963, Blue Note.
That's right, Freddie Roach. Soulful, soulful. Like I said, you got to be, you got to know something about this food, and you got to be able to express yourself musically.
Yeah, just like you enjoy the food on a good Sunday evening.
So that's what we're dealing with. We're dealing with a tasty jazz menu here on Riffin' on Jazz. And that's going to bring us to a cat that I know we've talked about, this guy.
We only mentioned, and we did not name, we did not do it, we haven't talked about it.
Nah, man. We talked about Charlie Mingus.
We only mentioned Mingus and people who played with Mingus.
Really?
We never have talked about Mingus.
Oh, my goodness. Oh, my goodness.
Who is considered to be one of the greatest jazz musicians of all time?
Bass player, pianist, composer, band leader, major proponent of collective improvisation. And, oh, my goodness, who hasn't he played with? Louis Armstrong, Duke Ellington, Charlie Parker, Dizzy, Herbie Hancock, even.
Yeah, no, man, that's a long way from Louis all the way down to Herbie. I mean, Herbie's not a spring chicken, but,
right.
I mean, that's a lot of distance.
Right, right. It is. Yeah. I mean, and he had a very, very broad storied career.
Yeah. Big bands and his orchestra and Mingus Dynasty and all of that good stuff.
All of that good stuff. And
that's where this track came from.
Yes, yes, yes. And so we have dealt with a variety of things for your palates, but now we're going to get into a song for Orange, and we want you to figure out if we're talking about orange the fruit, if we're talking about orange juice, or just what orange. We are talking orange sherbet. Charlie Mingus.
Thank you. Yeah.
the great Charles Mingus.
Now, please, Mingus
Dynasty
share with
Jazz Journeys presents The Birth of Bebop, 1960, Columbia Records.
Please share with our audience what you were saying about the diversity and the lineage of Charlie Mingus.
He said in his autobiography, the autobiography Beneath the Underdog, his mother was described as the daughter of an Englishman and a Chinese woman, and his father was the son of a black farm worker and a Swedish woman. Now that's a one-man diversity there.
Oh my God. An Englishman, a Chinese woman, an African American, and a Swedish woman. That's some diversity for you.
Well, he sure was. He was so legendary, and I'm surprised we hadn't talked about it before, though. In 93, the Library of Congress got his collected papers, included scores of sound recordings and correspondence and photos, and what they described as the most important acquisition of a manuscript collection relating to jazz in the library's history.
Wow. So we're going to go from that, and we're going to go out with somebody that you all know. This cat's name is Edward Hammond Boatner, Jr. And
we
of course,
Edward, about him
Edward Hammond.
Either. I can't believe we haven't talked about him before.
So how do you go from Edward Hammond Boatner, Jr. to a professional name of Sonny Stitt? Who does that? That's fantastic. That's what we're going to go out on. Sonny Stitt's going to be doing a tune called Soul Food. And we all know Sonny Stitt. Sonny Stitt was sometimes viewed as a Charlie Parker mimic.
Yeah.
But
he was one of the bebop masters.
Oh, my goodness. Warm song. And what a friend of my family's told me when he heard I was playing sax. Come here, boy. Sit down. Listen to this. Now, when you can play like this, this is when you know you can play. And he played a Sonny Stitt cut. So we're going to go out with Soul Food by Sonny Stitt. We have been talking about Tasty Jazz Menu here on Riffin on Jazz. And so, you know, we got to get out of here. But Malvin, you know, if we were cheese, they might call us aged.
Yeah, and if we were cars, they may call us classic. And if we were wine, they may call us vintage.
But that doesn't matter because we call ourselves blessed and very highly favored to be with you here on Riffin' on Jazz. I am Howard Robertson.
And I'm Malvin Massey.
And we ask you to be good, be well, and please be back with us next week for more Riffin' on Jazz.
Riffin' on Jazz. Executive produced by Kudzukian. Co-host by Howard Robertson and Malvin Massey Jr. Music curation by Howard and Malvin. And recorded at Kudzukian Studios. Riffin' on Jazz. Part of the Kudzukian Network. Thank you.
Thank you.